the last 50 years, as you can see from this graph, multiple myeloma therapy has been changed profoundly, starting from the 1960s with the steroid-based therapy until these days, where with the introduction of the so-called cellular therapies with CAR T therapies, the specific antibodies, and the monoclonal antibodies that have improved very rapidly also the survival of multiple myeloma patients. However, despite these significant advances in therapy, the natural clinical history of multiple myeloma showed an alternance of remission and relapse phases through this course. The clinical aim of multiple myeloma is to reach a remission phase and maintain this status as long as possible. To this aim, in the GenoMed4All project, we have in the multiple myeloma use case, we have included, we have enrolled 300 newly diagnosed multiple myeloma patients. And also, we are using an external cohort of nearly 1,000 patients newly diagnosed multiple myeloma from a public repository that is called COMPASS. And with the final aim to, as I said before, to refine the definition of high-risk patient, possibly by identifying predictors of early relapse patient within the 18 month from diagnosis, based on the integration of baseline genomic, clinical, and imaging data using artificial intelligence.